everything we have in stock in the 4 to 5 can range.
Mm. Haven't you anything larger?
Oh, yes, madam. But not blue-white. Those are extremely rare.
Mm. No, no, don't take them away. I may change my mind.
As you wish. I think this might interest you, madam. It's a 12.5 carat top white florist.
Oh. Mm. Yes. How much is that?
That would cost 200,000, approximately.
Mm. That is very attractive.
Yes, it is. I think that... As we say from Old
Trafford at... The stones. You. You. Hold this. Move.
Sorry, you can't go in there. It's been fumigated.
Fumigated?
Yeah, fumigated.
You mean cleaned up?
Exactly.
Shall we go somewhere else?
Yeah.
Give me that. It's 3-2 in a game to the seesaw. Come on! Should have scored there. United back, and now in the lead. The man that got the third goal to United was McAtee. He doesn't take forward again on Sunday. He's got so much heart, so much courage. I think he's still there, number two. The number two is Malone to Porterfield. Silver? It's just solid silver.
How much?
439 rep.
I'll take it. Don't move for 30 seconds.
What's the score? So there it is. Manchester United lead by 3-2. As I pass the balance of top of the order, we shall have the carry. So Alex Stepney comes out of his goal.
You know, it was very exciting.
The rules. Only then I realized I had seen it in your eyes. Too late, too late.
It was daylight robbery, happened right before mine. Such a daylight robbery, how could I be so unwise? It was daylight robbery, and I should have seen it coming. Such a daylight robbery, and now you got me running.
Hey, that was great, but let's do it once more.
Okay. One, two, three, four.
Seen worse. Can't say fairer than that.
What's the name of this group playing here?
Them? Use Your Eyes.
Here. Do they practice all the time?
They ought to.
I mean, what time do they finish?
About an hour or so.
Great. Thanks very much.
It's in your breast pocket.
No, man.
It's in your breast pocket.
Okay, Chief, take it away.
Do you, who live in Rendsburg, take Claudie, Mary, Martha, Lillian, Ida, Porchita, to be your lawful wedded wife?
I beg yours?
Do you, who live in Rendsburg, take Claudie, Mary, Martha, Lillian, Ida, Porchita, to be your lawful wedded wife?
You never told me you had all these names, Claudie?
Well, I have.
Why?
Why what?
Why have you got all these names?
Well, I was called Claudie because my dad liked the name, and Mary was my gran's name, and Martha was my gran's name, and my auntie was Lillian, and Ida was my godmother.
Oh. Why were you called Porchita?
That was my dad's name.
You didn't tell me all this, Claudie.
Look, may we continue? I've got four more couples waiting to get married.
Yeah, I'm sorry, sir, but I didn't know she had all these names. I mean, I've only got one, and that's quite enough for me.
Willie, the magistrate is waiting.
I'm sorry, sir. Your Worship, Your Honour, Your Grace. Chief.
Do you, Willie von Rensburg, take Claudie, Mary, Martha, Lillian, Ida, Porchita to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do. Did I do it right?
Yeah.
And do you, Claudie, Mary, Martha, Lillian, Ida, Porchita, take Willie von Rensburg to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do. I mean, she does.
Shh. I does.
Listen, Blanche, a slight snag has cropped up. The Stones and I parted company, temporarily, that is.
What are you talking about?
I mean, I had to dump them a bit smartish. But don't worry, I'll get them back later on the day. They're as safe as ours.
Mrs. Rensburg? Is that?
Me?
Yes. Mr. Von Rensburg?
Well, that's everything. I declare you man and wife. I hope you both be very happy.
It's funny how women at the happiest moment in their lives start crying.
That's not why I'm crying.
Why are you crying, Claudie?
I think I made a terrible mistake.
That's everything. Except this gun box.
That should have gone in first.
Then we're gonna have to start again.
You're so right.
Well, I don't like it.
You don't have to like
Lizzie
it.
Lizzie Knuckles, I said I don't like it.
The first part of the job went off like a dream.
Yeah, maybe, but where's the stones now?
Keep your voice down, will you?
Where's the million rand?
Oh, do you have to wear that fur?
It gives me hay fever.
Okay, let's start again.
First of all, I'd like to thank...
My mom.
My mom.
My dad.
And my dad.
Your mom.
Your mom.
Your dad.
Your dad.
My Auntie Ida for my wedding dress.
And my Auntie Ida for my wedding dress. I mean, her wedding dress.
And... The grocer for the wedding cake?
Oh, yes, the grocer for the wedding cake. Grocers don't make wedding cakes.
Ours did.
Ours did.
And Nora for the flowers?
And Nora. Thanks, Nora, for the flowers.
And I think that's all.
And I think that's all. Thanks.
Nice beat, Willie.
I want to know. Cake, Willie, cake!
Ah, yes, the cake! The cake!
Sounds like a drum. I'll try the second story.
Anyone like a piece of cake?
Oh, that's the way to do it, Tony.
Yes, but it still doesn't seem right to me.
Where does this go, Clive?
There goes some more of them. Look. In and out, every 5 minutes.
Where do we stick this, Clive?
I'd like to tell you.
Don't you worry about the stones. They're as safe as houses. No one would go near them. They'd get their eardrums blasted.
Look, if we don't stop arguing, we're never going to get to Rhodesia.
Well, I don't want to travel the whole way to Rhodesia with a drum box on my lap.
Well, sit on it then.
Is anyone any better suggestions? Right, let's go.
Hey, Willie. Yeah, Willie, where are we going?
Yes.
Derby?
No.
B?
No.
Cape Town?
No.
Oh, I give up.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Oh, no, none of me, silly. Where are we going?
Don't tell them, but Rhodesia.
Rhodes! Fantastic!
Hey, look what this bird did. I'll leave it. Come on,
too much noise, Blanche. There won't be anybody about.
Be quiet, just in case.
Anything you say, just get the diamonds.
Go.
The diamonds?
Yeah. You wait here. See you later.
Yes, Lieutenant. And then the lady said she'd see if there were any policemen in the street, and out she went.
And she hasn't been back again since?
No, sir.
What did she look like?
Well, she was sort of... Well, it's very hard to explain.
A general description will do. Let's start at the bottom.
The bottom? Well, it was...
No. I should have said start at the beginning. Think about it. I'll come back to you in a moment. Start again. Found anything?
Not yet, sir. No, sir. Worth a try, though.
You're new, aren't you?
No, sir. Lewis. Oh, yes, sir. I see what you mean.
Well, do a good job and you'll get promotion.
Oh, thank you, sir. I always do my best, sir. Aha! Oh, beg your pardon, sir.
Lewis, eh?
This will keep me going till lunchtime.
What is the matter?
We got a puncture and we haven't even got a check.
You know, only you could go 50 miles off the main road for a cup of tea. Now what are you going to do?
Don't worry, Claudie. Cometh the hour, cometh the man.
What is that supposed to mean?
I don't know, but it sounds good.
Are you sure you haven't got a jack?
No. I mean, yes, I'm sure I have no jack.
You know, I knew I'd made a mistake marrying you.
Don't worry, Claudine. We'll get the car going again. And when we get to the next town, we can stop. And you can get a divorce.
Thanks.
They're the plates, babe.
Won't you put them on the table?
Yeah.
That's going to spoil your lunch.
It's just an hors d'oeuvre. What are we having?
Scrambled eggs.
How many eggs have you got?
One.
That'll never be enough.
You want a bed? Voila.
Look, Claudie. What did I tell you? Cometh the hour, cometh the man.
How was it?
It was great.
Mm, no, not bad.
You're okay, Tony?
Fabulous, thanks. Hey, you missed a bit.
Yeah, boy.
Hey, Con.
Yeah, Uncle.
I took those years and shook them like a toy. While the world slept, I was a hunter, riding on the wind and on the rain.
I laughed at the strike. Quiet, I'm auditioning this boy. It's very rude to come barge in here while I'm auditioning.
It'll only take a second. All I want to do is sit down and keep quiet.
Returning,
you carry on, dear. Don't let me put you off.
Who knows the last day of summer? Who knows the balancing point when the year fades? It's in a great touch, in a great touch. If only I'd known.
Come on, Harry, I haven't got all day. Now look what you've gone and done. He stopped because you come barging in here like a steam engine. Some people. What do you want?
You've got to do me a favor, Harry. Please?
Get yourself a Coke. I'll hear the rest of your act in 10 minutes.
Right, Harry. Okay.
Very talented boy, you know.
Yeah.
Very talented.
Yeah.
Now you've got my undivided attention. What do you want, Knuckles, dear?
I want to find out where this group's playing.
Well, that should be easy enough. I didn't know you were interested in pop music.
Well, I wasn't. But, I am now. Very.
Joseph, help here.
That's all right, it's not heavy. Over the holes and I'll put the mask back. There.
That's right.
There,
hold
there.
It there.
That's right. Up a bit more.
Now,
over the hole. You're doing
well, Claudie.
Lucky you did that course of tech, eh?
What's wrong?
Oh, crooked.
Get it straight, then.
And it will not be necessary unless there is a further deterioration in the current situation. In a daring daylight robbery from a Johannesburg jeweller's today, a masked man got away with diamonds worth more than 1 million rand. The police are pursuing their investigations, but no arrest has been made as yet. And finally, in Memphis, Tennessee, a night watchman named Sammy, who has 2 wooden legs, was on fire-watching duty last night when the building caught alight. The fire brigade managed to save the building, but Sammy was burnt to the ground.
Thank you for the spade, Joseph. Thank you. Thank you.
Do you know there was a tear in the altered monitor speaker?
Yeah, it looks a bit tacky, doesn't it?
Do you think you could fix it?
I could try.
Here, got a light. Here, Tom.
Good matches, those.
British.
Everyone's a striker.
Sorry.
Ah. Hello.
Yes?
Oh, great. Just let me write that down.
Yes? 724-21-31. Thank you.
Thanks, Harry. You're a darling, son.
Knuckles.
What?
You got my thanks.
Oh, yeah. Harry, you got my pen.
Oh, yeah.
Come.
Hey, Knuckles! Knuckles, you got my matches!
Excuse me, miss, is this your car?
Yes, it's my husband's.
Well, you know your meter's run out.
Well, I put 5 cents in and nothing happened.
Really?
Oh.
Here, let me have a go.
What's the trouble?
Well, you see, the thing's expired and I've pulled
out... All right, all right, hold on. I'll sort this out.
You're a Jill of Paul Jackson and Jill, aren't you?
That's right.
I've got all your records, you know.
Have you? Ah.
I'm what you might call a fan.
Thank you. Don't you want to look at our passports?
Huh?
Our passports. Oh, yeah.
Are you not, nearly so pretty in your photograph, huh?
That's Tony, our drummer.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye. Pull yourself together, Duplessis.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Well, where's your smallpox certificate?
That traffic cop got nasty.
Maybe not, but you shouldn't have argued. The last thing I need at this moment is silly petty rows. I've got more important things on my mind.
You found out where the band is?
Yeah, Fort Victoria.
Where's that?
Rhodesia, near the Zimbabwe ruins.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, the band will be there tonight and so will we.
How are we going to get there?
Fly.
What are we going to do when we get there?
I'm taking you to a show. Bit of culture.
Afternoon, can I help you?
Yeah.
Here we are, Mr. and Mrs. Sampson, at Zimbabwe. Dinner will be served at 7:30.
Hey, thanks very much, love. Herbert. Herbert.
Huh?
Wake up, we're here.
Huh? Where?
Here.
Where's here?
I don't know, but we're at the hotel at any rate.
Oh, good.
If there is anything I can do for you, please don't hesitate to ask me.
Fanny, shall we go to the ruins tomorrow?
Yeah, only after breakfast.
Let's have a look at your passport photo, Claudie.
Only if you show me yours.
Okay.
Okay.
Yuck, but you're pretty, eh, Claudie?
Thanks. Okay. Now let's have a look at yours.
Promise you won't laugh.
No, no. I promise. Honest.
You promised you wouldn't laugh. Come on, give it back.
No, let's have another look.
Oh, no, come on, Claudie, we're wasting time. Man.
Thanks.
So?
Well, let's have a look at yours. Harry, the border closes in a few minutes.
So what are you laughing at?
Nobody.
Come on, Willie, the border will be closed.
What was he laughing at?
I don't know.
It was my passport photo, wasn't it?
I guess so.
I'm going back to Dornery.
If you do that, the border will be closed. And if we don't get into Rhodesia tonight, we won't be able to find a hotel. And if we can't find a hotel, we will have nowhere to sleep tonight, Willie.
All right. I'll Dornery him on the way back.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Me too, also.
Why didn't you book us a hotel, Willie?
How was I to know that it would be full?
You could have checked and made sure.
How?
Could have made a phone call.
You know we're not on the phone.
You could have phoned from the office.
Mr. Kloppers doesn't like me making personal calls. Well, what do you suggest we do?
All we can do is what the customs man suggested.
What did he suggest?
We spend the night by the Botbridge Reservoir.
Jan, I can do some fishing.
What am I supposed to do?
You can dig for worms.
I'm going off now, sir.
All right, Lewis. Good night, Lewis.
Good night, sir.
Check those birds in the second row.
Where?
Just to the right of the arm.
Yeah. Wow.
Don't like the look of yours much.
Hey, what are you two doing?
I was just looking to see if my grandma's here.
Oh, come on.
You think we could start now?
Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, the four Jacks and a Jill.
Give me just a bit of that sweet, sweet love that you're handing out. And I'll give you just a bit of my sweet, sweet love in return. Give me just a bit of that sweet, sweet love that you're handing out. And I'll give you so much love that your sweet, sweet heart will just burn.
My cough medicine, love. Oh. Herbert? Herbert! Gone out again. No wonder he's so tired during the daytime. Ah.
Why are you crying, Claudie?
Because everything's gone wrong.
But you mustn't cry on our honeymoon. I'll show you my picture in my passport. That'll cheer you up.
Oh, you silly.
Night, Claudie.
Night, Willie.
Thank you so much. You have been the most fantastic audience, you know that. Would you like to come out for coffee? Yeah! I think we'll have enough. Okay, I'll tell you what. We would love to do one more song for you. In fact, I'd like to stand here and chat to you all night. You've been so nice. But seeing we do all have homes to go to, there is one more song which we'd like to do. And you've been so super, I'd like to dedicate the first few lines of it to you. Thank you.
cousins is it?
It was too far.
It was not that sweet.
It was too far.
Claudie?
What is it now, Willie?
I just thought of something.
What?
I know why this place is called Bike Bridge. Gotcha.
Why is it called Bike Bridge, Willie?
Because... forget it. Night, Claudie.
Night, Willie.
It was too fast, wasn't it, Tony?
Yeah. No. Yes. Don't involve me.
Well, can we have a rehearsal then, Clive?
Okay, after we've had something to eat, but let's get a move on because we've got a heavy day tomorrow.
Well, thank you for a lovely evening, Mr. Sampson.
Yes, Miss Fuller, love. It has been a lovely evening. So far.
Good night.
By the way, Miss Fuller, love.
Yes, Mr. Sampson.
What's your first name?
Delilah. Good night.
Mr. Sampson and Delilah.
What are you doing?
I nearly had it then. Why don't you go and get yourself a cup of tea?
Please yourself.
Hey, Blanche.
Yeah.
You look really beautiful tonight.
Oh, that was great. Glad you enjoyed it.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, this is a bit steep. I thought your sign outside said food at popular prices.
Well, I like them.
These guys take advantage of one, you know?
For sure.
Have you heard that all cafe owners in Greece are Rhodesian?
Thank you.
Coffee, please.
Enjoyed your show.
Oh, thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed it. I don't think this rehearsal was such a good idea. I'm tired. I could do with some sleep.
Oh, come on, Clive. It won't take long. Besides, it was too fast.
Let's not start that again. Let's rather just rehearse, pack up and go.
Hi, fellas.
How did you get in here?
I came through the stage door.
Forget it. I locked it.
No, you didn't. Oh, I'm from the London Daily Mirror. You are the Four Jacks in the Jill, aren't you?
Who else?
Oh, well, I thought I'd... do a story on you. Move up, love.
It's nice of life.
Yeah, I suppose so. We're only doing a few bars of one number and then we're packing up our gear.
But you can't leave all this equipment in the truck. It might get swiped.
No, it's quite safe. Josh sleeps in the truck at night. He can't stand hotel rooms.
Oh.
Why doesn't he come to Bulawayo? We'll be there tomorrow night.
Yeah. Well, I'll go then.
Okay, cheers.
Cheers. Bye.
Bye. Good night. Where do you think you've been?
I've been getting ready.
For what?
For you. Come here, you luscious, ravishing, tantalizing creature.
Herbert, go to sleep immediately.
Oh, what a relief.
Have you got one? Mm-mm. Why not?
The group came back.
Where exactly are the diamonds?
Wouldn't you like to know?
If you help those kids, I'll leave you.
You won't leave me and you know it.
Thank you, sir.
I'm not paying that.
No, I'm certainly not paying it.
Look, I don't care who pays it.
Well, you pay for it then.
Hey, Willie, there was vandals here, hey? Vandals. There were four large stone columns with Zimbabwe birds on the top. Now, when the first explorer came here, he decided he wanted to take one home with him. But you see, the columns together were too heavy. So he took a hammer and he knocked a bird off. Hey, Willie, you're not listening to me.
Yes, I am.
What did I say then?
You said this explorer knocked this bird off.
I think the Africans built this place.
Forget it. Who do you reckon built it then?
I think the Africans built it.
Why?
No white man's gonna lay all these bricks.
What do you feel, Tony?
Hungry.
Outside, it's a duff car, that's what's the matter.
What you gonna do?
I don't know. Go back to the garage and get a breakdown truck, I suppose. Nothing else for it. You wait here. Rubbish, you hired me. Can you get it fixed?
Oh, not for another 24 hours, I'm afraid, sir.
Not for another 24 hours? Well, can you hire me another car then?
You won't get another car. I'm the only car hire firm here.
Well, then how do you think I'm going to get to Bulawayo?
Oh, you could fly.
You can forget about flying.
Well, how are we going to get there then, Walk?
Excuse me.
Can I help you?
Yes, please, sir. I'm interested in the African drum in the window.
African drum? Certainly, certainly. Is this the one?
It's a bit flat.
Flat?
Tone doesn't carry.
Tone? Not flat.
How much is it?
$20.
No, I don't think so.
It's not flat.
No, I think I'll leave it.
19?
No, thanks.
Glenn? I'm stuck.
Oh, Tony. You mean you're really stuck?
Yeah. Don't. I'm stuck. I'm really stuck. How much is this?
$100.
Any discount for cash?
All right. $90.
Glenn, can you lend me $90?
It might not matter when I'm thinking of you. I lay my eyes on you and baby, I'm through. Oh, what an involvement, a one-sided affair. I thought that we'd be.
become a compliment. You had potential, thought I'd give it a blow. On approbation, your credentials were low. Now parting company is planned 23. But fate has turned the tables, now you're stuck on me. We're swinging together, woo, living together. Life couldn't be better, but oh, I could never stay with you for stuck like glue. You proved to me you're worse than scrap. Oh, inspiration, won't you get off my back? Not mine over matter, now you're part of my life. You've sneaked in closer than a beautiful wife. Before we met, I didn't harbor a care. But choosing you initially was my love affair. Oh, inspiration, won't you? Matter now, you're part of my life. You've sneaked in closer than a beautiful wife. Before we met, I didn't harbor a care. But choosing you initially was not so unfair. We're swinging together, woo, living together. We're swinging together.
Can I help you?
Excuse me, we're looking for a bed, room.
I'm terribly sorry, we're fully booked.
Fully booked?
I'm afraid so, yes.
But we tried every hotel in town. This was our last hope of getting a bed, room.
Well, you see, there's the trade fair on in town.
The trade fair?
Yes, we're chock-a-block.
Chock-a-block?
Yes, you see, all the people round about have come to see four Jackson and Jill.
Jackson and Jill.
Yes. I'm afraid there's not a room to be had. I'm sorry.
Yes, oh, no.
Well, there's only one thing for it, Cody.
No?
We'll have to get a bigger car.
No.
It's no good. You're just going to have to get another drummer.
Why?
I can't walk to Victoria Falls.
Oh, you can ride on the roof.
300 miles, you'll just have to get another drum.
Look, can't we all try and pull it off?
That's a good idea. Okay, Tony. Glenn, you and Mike take the speed. Josh and I take the upper half. When I say pull, you all pull, okay? Now, let's go.
Okay.
Pull! Ah! Oh!
Come on, pull!
Ah!
Oh! Oh, hang on.
Ah!
Wait a minute, I'll go and get some more people. Never mind more people, you'll just have to get another drum.
It's no good. You'll have to get another singer.
Tonight, Claudie, we're going to spend the night in a nice, quiet, small place. Far away from trade fairs and the four Jacks and the Jill and people. Tonight we're going to be sure of getting a room. A bed. Bedroom. I was right the first time.
Where have you decided, Willie?
Victoria Falls.
Hmm?
It says here in this brochure, they got so much room they don't know what to do with it.
I don't believe it.
Look, we've got so much room, we don't know what to do with it.
Hey, lady, can you perhaps give me a lift to Victoria Falls?
Oh, I'm sorry, but we're full up. Hey, you lost a shoe.
No, I just found one.
Hey, Willie, wake up, man.
What?
Wake up, man, you nearly crashed the car. We need a kit, man. Pull up properly over there. Once we've had a rest, we'll see game for Africa.
Good thinking. See you later, Claudie.
Okay, Willie. See you later too, eh?
glad we haven't got a show tonight.
Yeah. What are the others doing?
Glenn's gone for a walk, Clive's fixing the sound, and Tony's gone for something to eat. Shall we rehearse?
Yeah.
I just dozed off for a bit.
For a bit? You've been asleep for 2 hours.
Oh, what's the time?
Half past four.
Oh, good. It'll be getting cool soon. The animals will be coming out for a walk. If we keep our eyes peeled, we should see tons of game. Especially the big ones.
We didn't see any game. Excuse me, we'd like a room.
Yes, certainly.
Did you hear that, Claudie? They've got a room.
Yes, I heard.
What name, please?
Mr. Van Rensburg and Miss Portpeter.
Van Rensburg.
Van Rensburg.
Two rooms?
No, just one.
I'm afraid I can't allow that. You've got to be married to share a room.
Oh, but we are married. I'm Mr. Van Rensburg and this is my wife, Miss Portpeter.
Van Rensburg.
Miss Van Rensburg.
Mrs. Van Rensburg.
What's my mother got to do with it?
No, silly. Mrs. Van Rensburg, that's my name too now.
Is it? Oh, yes. No, it is. I'd like a room for tonight, for myself and for my wife here, Mrs. Van Rensburg.
Are you sure you're married?
Yes, quite sure.
Cross my heart.
Well then, sign here, please.
We're going to get a room, Claudie. Can you believe it? We're going to get a room. I don't want to be disloyal to the car, but it's much better to have a bed, a room, a bedroom.
The danger, the thrills, and the facts when the long arm of the law travels in squad cars.
Come on.
car. So, first time at the falls?
Why, we've been on this safari.
Oh, so where have you been so far?
Well, we've been to Cape Town and Durban and Johannesburg.
Hey, and then we come up here, and then we went to Zimbabwe, and then to Bulla Watford.
Oh, I see. So you've certainly been around quite a lot, haven't you?
That's a lot, Service. We and I'll have a pickle gherkin. I won't have a drink, Tom.
I'll buy our brewery when I pick up them stones.
Oh, when'll that be?
When I'm ready.
Where you been anyway?
Getting organised.
What for?
Look, we're at the Victoria Falls now, right? Mm. It is right on the border. Right. You pick up the stones, cross over, and get a plane to Amsterdam.
You never said nothing about going away.
So what?
When do we get back?
I suppose we will. It wouldn't be safe. But stop giving me a hard time. I'm sick and tired of this country anyway.
Suppose then I don't want to go to Amsterdam. This is my home.
You'll do what I tell you.
Shh. People are looking at us.
So what? Let them look. Bunch of suckers work like dogs all day. And what have they got to show themselves? Nothing.
At least it's honest work.
You make me sick.
Yeah, maybe I do. But I've put up with a lot from you, Knuckles. And I'm just beginning to wonder why.
Blanche, come back here. Blanche, how dare you walk out on me? Come back here!
Excuse me, sir. You haven't paid.
What?
Well? Aren't you going to hit me? That's usually the way it ends up.
I'm warning you, Blanche, you'll go too far in a minute.
Doesn't matter. With your going to Amsterdam, it's goodbye anyway.
All right, then. If that's the way you feel, why don't you walk out now?
If you go to Amsterdam or whatever, you'll be the one that's doing the walking out. At least I'll have that satisfaction.
I was talking to those kids in the band earlier on. I've never dreamt of that much money. Probably never will. But they're happy. They enjoy their work. Enjoy their relaxation. They enjoy life.
So what? So do we. Don't we?
You and me. We don't know what the word means.
Listen, all my life I've been bogged down with lousy dead-end jobs with a few petty crimes to fill in. Well, I can see the light now, the end of the tunnel. For the first time in my life, I can see the prospect of being able to sit down and enjoy life. So I'm going to take that R1 million, and I'm going to run for the end of that tunnel. And there ain't nobody going to stop me. Nobody.
I wouldn't stop you, Knuckles. Just don't hurt anybody. That's all I ask. I really hope the money brings you happiness. I really do. Everyone deserves a little happiness. Even you, Knuckles, love. Just be careful, please. Everything you've ever given me has been nicked.
Yeah, I know. It's the story of my life, isn't it? Well, let me tell you something, Blanche. Chances like this don't come very often, and when they do, you've got to grab them. Most people don't realise that. That's why most people are losers. You're a loser. A born loser.
Hold it, Claudie.
No,
I'm going to fix the sound system.
Come on, let's get spoiled for
woman.
Bring the camera, Claudia. I've just seen our first big game. Come on, Frieda, poke your head out.
A blooming tortoise. And how do you know it's a girl?
It must be. Frederick would have done what he was told. Come on, Frieda. It's no good hiding. We know you're in there. Come on.
Hello, boys.
Hi, Blanche. Hi. Care to join us?
Yes, love to.
Give the lady your chair, Josh. He's a gentleman.
No. Not many of them about.
Yeah, that's true.
Do you like some tea?
Yes, love some.
You haven't seen Glynis by any chance, have you?
No.
She said she was going to fix the sound system. We haven't seen her since. And she wasn't at the hall.
You look a little worried, Blanche.
Hey, you! I want a word with you.
What's the matter?
First of all, my wife and I haven't been able to get a room because of you. Oh, by the way, this is my wife, Miss Portkitter.
How do you do?
Mrs. van Rensburg.
Stop bringing my mother into this. And secondly, that Jill of yours nearly ran over me just now.
She did?
Where?
Down the road there. I was photographing this tortoise, you see. It was the first big game we'd seen.
Was she in a blue Peugeot?
The tortoise?
No, the Jill. Yes, she was in a blue Peugeot.
Were the man in denims?
I don't know. I was photographing Frida.
The tortoise.
Yes.
But the Jill was with the man in blue denims.
Oh, come on, Clive. I think Glynis is in trouble.
Hey, you. I want a word with you when you get back.
Yes. Listen to me. A couple of days ago in Joburg, there was a diamond robbery,
yes,
right?
Yes, I know, I know.
Well, Knuckles did the job.
Knuckles did the job?
Yes,
you're kidding.
Yes, I'm not kidding at all, Clive. Now, listen to me. Hit the diamonds in your equipment.
In our equipment?
Yeah. And I think that Glynis found the diamond.
Yeah, yeah.
And Knuckles found Glynis.
Yeah, but where would he have taken her, Blanche?
Probably across the border.
Have you got a boat?
I don't know, maybe.
You'll be uprooted then.
No, listen, I'm coming with
no,
you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
You're not.
Clive, you don't know Knuckles.
This is a fine example of a baobab tree.
Aye, it's big, isn't it? There's that rough fellow shouting about in the bar last night. He's got the Jill with him.
Or otherwise known as the cream of tartar tree.
I wonder what she's doing with the likes of him.
Have you seen her?
Down there in the blue.